application of I effect. Write down next. Application of I effect. Mainly two types of application we have. Write down. Two types of application we have. To compare the stability of intermediate. To compare the stability of intermediates. And the second application you write down. To compare the acid base strength. To compare the acid base strength. Okay, first one we'll see. How do we compare? Write your notes properly, okay? This helps you a lot, all these notes, okay? In exam time. So all of you write your notes properly of this organic chemistry especially. It's very important. First one, stability of intermediate, okay? So what are intermediates, first of all? Intermediates are, write down, intermediates are highly unstable molecules or ions, molecules or ions, which forms during the reaction and gets destroyed before completing the reaction. Okay, so during the reaction it forms with, when the reaction proceeds, it forms an intermediate in between, and then before completing the reaction, before formation of product, it destroys also. Okay, so basically, in general, we'll write what reactants gives you intermediate first, and this intermediate converts into product. Okay, now yahan pe we will have certain conditions to convert this into product. There are two barriers which every intermediate has to overcome, and that is energy barrier and orientation barrier, and that we'll discuss in chemical kinetics. Okay, that is not required here. Okay, but any reaction proceeds, reactant first gives highly unstable intermediate. Kisi bhi reaction mein intermediate can never be a product. Final product kabhi bhi intermediate nahi ho sakta hai, because its energy is very high, and hence it is highly unstable. So it has to convert into product if the condition, if the barrier is there, if the condition is satisfied basically. If the condition is not satisfied, then it converts back into reactant. We won't get intermediate as a final product in the reaction. This is one thing. Now, what are the different intermediates? Okay, write down next. There are different intermediates we have. The first one is carbocation. The second one is free radical. One by one, we'll discuss this. The third one is carbon ion. The fourth one is carbenes. The fifth one is nitrines. Benzene. Benzene is not that important. Yahan se question bhi nahi aayenge. But all these intermediates are important. Okay, it is there in the reaction, which we'll discuss later on in organic.
What's the third one?
Carbon ion. Carbon में negative charge अगर होगा तो carbon ion. Carbon में positive charge है तो carbocation. What is the carbocation? Write down next.
Sir, so what's fifth one?
Fifth one, nitrines. Nitrines, carbenes, benzene. Benzene ऐसा कुछ होता है. We'll discuss this part में. Benzene is like this. It's highly unstable. Carbocation, write down. So what is a carbocation and its property kya hai? That we'll see first. Okay. So carbocation is a carbon atom which has three sigma bond. This X, Y, Z can be anything. It has three sigma bond and one vacant orbital. Three sigma bond and one vacant orbital with a positive charge on this carbon. This carbocation has three sigma bond characteristics, three sigma bond, one vacant p orbital.
So what happened here? I think.
Huh? We'll start after some time. Just finish this and then this.
So what all did we do?
Sir, what is this?
So brief,
can't give you any. See, what we are discussing, GOC, General Organic Chemistry. These are intermediates.
It's recorded.
I'll share the video. I have already recorded the video, so I'll share that. One way, just for this, you just understand, we are discussing an intermediate carbocation and stability of this intermediate on the basis of inductive effect, which we have discussed. Okay, so that one we'll do, and then we'll stop this, we'll continue with ironing. Okay, we'll finish ironing and then we can continue with this again. Okay, so one vacant p orbital, 3 sigma bond, one vacant p orbital, right? It has how many electrons? 6 electrons, 2, 4, 5 and 6. It has 6 electrons, hence it is electron deficient. Electron deficient. To gain octet, it has tendency to accept one pair of electron, right? That's why this behaves as Lewis acid. Okay? It has tendency to accept one pair of electron, behaves as Lewis acid. Next one, it is diamagnetic. Why it is diamagnetic? All electrons are paired, diamagnetic, right? What is the hybridization? sp2, 3 sigma bond, sp2 hybridization. What is the geometry? Trigonal. This is the characteristics of carbocation.
So
okay.
Is this a specific kind of carbocation, or all have this?
It's carbocation. It is carbocation, not specific. Whenever you have carbocation, these are the characteristics of carbocation. Okay, 3 bond pair and 1 vacant pure. Carbocation, carbon has 3 sigma bond and 1 vacant orbital. Vacant orbital means what? One electron is missing over there. That's why one positive charge is there. And one electron is completely missing. That's why we have what? We have a complete charge. Delta positive nearly common. Positive charge, right? Delta positive, when you write, it's non-classical carbocation. The partial charge hota hai, toh usko non-classical bolte. Not important, but kahi bolna mat bol dena, acha lagega. Non-classical carbocation. Sab kuch feel aayega, but not important. Okay? Delta positive likha hua hai, non-classical carbocation. These are classical carbocation. Completely developed charge, right? So now the stability of this carbocation is affected by all kind of electronic effects, whether it is I effect, mesomeric effect, resonance, hyperconjugation. Some say stability effect, right? When you finish this chapter, when you get the question in the exam, you have to find out in the given molecule what electronic effects is possible. Resonance, what I effect, hyperconjugation. And according to that, you have to decide which one is dominating. Okay? To dominate, according will find out the stability of carbocation. But we have done till now, we have only done I effect. So we will do the stability comparison on the basis of I effect only. Once we finish all the electronic effects, we will take some example and then we will see what effect is possible, which one is dominating. According to that, what should be the order. Okay? So we will talk about it. Next, write down the stability of carbocation. So in organic chemistry, like I said, neutral species is always more stable than the charged one. Correct? So when you have a positive charge, so to gain stability, this positive charge you have to minimize. Positive density you have to minimize. So this stability of positive charge is affected by plus I effect and minus I effect, obviously. But what is the relation we have of the stability of carbocation with plus I effect and carbocation with minus I effect? So the stability of carbocation, to gain stability, the charge density we have to reduce. Yes or no? Stability of carbocation, the charge density we have to reduce. To reduce positive charge density, what we have to do? We have to provide electrons. And electrons can be given by minus I group or plus I group? Plus I group. Plus I groups are electron releasing group. So that's why the stability of carbocation is directly proportional to plus I effect and inversely proportional to minus I. Okay? So one thing is there that you have to minimize the charge density. Got it? Charge density you have to minimize. Okay? According to that only we'll decide the stability. Okay? Plus I and minus I. We'll write down some examples and then we'll compare. Compare the stability of these carbocations. CH3, CH2, positive charge. CH3, CH, CH3, positive charge, CH3, C, CH3, compare the stability of the three.
First one is the most.
So what's CD3?
CD3 is, it's, you can consider this as CH3, but H is replaced by the isotope of hydrogen, that is deuterium.
No, they're not.
Finish all these words, then we'll discuss. क्या होगा बताओ आंसर ओके फर्स्ट वन विच वन इज द मोस्ट स्टेबल व्हाई थर्ड वन सी जस्ट अ सेकंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू कंपेयर द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस कार्बोकैटायन ओके एल्काइल ग्रुप्स आर इलेक्ट्रॉन रिलीजिंग ग्रुप एल्काइल ग्रुप्स आर इलेक्ट्रॉन रिलीजिंग ग्रुप There are three electron releasing groups, the positive density here it is minimum out of the three. Okay? That's why its stability is maximum. So this is first, this is second, and this one is third. Okay, order. This is the most stable. First means most stable, third means least stable. This F shows what?
The F shows maximum I minus.
Electron withdrawing, minus I effect. Okay? Chlorine ka. Will have minus I effect. Chlorine also minus I and bromine also minus I. But out of the three, which one has maximum minus I effect? Chlorine. So this withdraws more electron, maximum electron. So here the positive density increases, right? And it is maximum, here it is minimum. So this is most stable. One, this is two, and this is three. Order of stability.
Wait, so can you repeat what you said about, you know, the arrows, that
arrows means these are releasing electron.
Okay.
Arrow means releasing electron. This means withdrawing electron towards its side. Ah, what happened, Ruchit? Bolo.
Take
your
time.
Okay. CS3 is what? Plus I effect. CD3 is? Sorry, plus I, Cl3 is, Cl is minus I and F is again minus I. Plus I, you see, plus I stabilizes the stability, the carbocation and minus I destabilizes the carbocation. Okay, so obviously these two stabilize the carbocation and these two destabilize the carbocation, right? So, Cl3 and CD3, which one has more plus I effect? CD3 maximum, then CD3 and then CS3. CD3 has more plus I nature, it means it releases more electron, hence this one is most stable, the first one is.
Sir, but don't neutrons only affect the physical properties?
No.
More mass, right? No, does it?
Because of more mass, only its electron releasing tendency is more.
So, but how will mass affect your
electron? When mass number increases, the bond, the vibration of bond pair will be less, and that will decrease the bond length. ठीक है इतना कुछ सोचना नहीं है मैंने ऑर्डर दिया क्या दिया ऑर्डर CD3 has maximum plus I and CS3 has minimum plus I out of the three. Okay?
So more the mass
don't get confused. Order is this. CD3, the plus I nature is this. CD3 and CS3. With this order, you can do the question. First of all,
answer
is
greater than
second. Oh, sorry. Okay. With this order, you can do the question. Why the order is maximum here? Because the bond length is minimum or maximum. The bond length here is minimum. So it has maximum electron releasing nature. That is more than enough. Okay. This order you must remember. CD3 has more plus I nature first, and this one is second. F has more minus I, so this will be fourth, and this will be third. Is it clear? Okay. In this two, this is minus I, and here we have CS3. Electron releasing group, so it is plus I. So plus I, stabilized carbocation, order will be this. Order of stability. Oxygen, electron withdrawing. Nitrogen also electron withdrawing. Okay? But which one has more electron withdrawing tendency?
O.
O, because O is more electronegative than nitrogen. So this one is less stable than this. Order is this.
That's NH.
NH, yes.
It
will
withdraw from H as well.
Yeah.
It will withdraw from H as well.
Is that
what? But that we are not considering. We are considering this positive charge stability.
No, sir. Because it withdraws more from H, does that mean that it will withdraw lesser from the positive charge?
No. Nitrogen. This oxygen pulls electron from this. This also pulls electron. And in this way, the positive charge density increases. Here also increases. But this can pull lesser electron than this. Because this is more electronegative. So here the electron density is, positive charge density is more here in comparison to this. And as positive charge density increases, stability decreases.
So, but what the N charge will pull electrons?
This will pull electron, that's why this hydrogen becomes slightly acidic. But this won't affect the electron withdrawing tendency of nitrogen versus.
So, sir, you told that if one atom pulls electrons, then the one behind will pull electrons. So, basically, example, if you give tetrahedral structure, that will produce a tetrahedral structure. See, sir, so you told that if one electron pulls electrons, one atom pulls electrons, then the one behind will pull electrons.
That also pulls electrons.
Yeah. So, that's what I'm not
confused. One atom pulls electron and other one releases electron. Yeah, this takes from this, this also takes from this electron. It depends what atom is attached to. It depends on the electronegative this and this atom. If this is less electronegative than this, then this pulls electron from this also and this. It depends upon the electronegative. What is the order here? This is most stable and least stable. This one
between 5 and 6.
Huh?
What are you looking for?
This carbon, we have 3 electron releasing group. Here we have only 2. Here we have only 1. So 3 electron releasing group, more less density and more stable. Okay. This one, you see, the carbon, positive charge carbon is attached with 3 alkyl group. This is tertiary carbocation, 3 degree carbocation or tertiary carbocation. Okay? When the positive charge carbon attached with two alkyl group, it is 2 degree or secondary carbocation. 3 degree or tertiary. It is 2 degree or secondary. It is 1 degree or primary carbocation. Okay? Similarly, so what we can conclude, 3 degree or tertiary carbocation is most stable. 3 degree, 2 degree and 1 degree. Here also the same thing. This is 3 degree carbocation. This is 2 degree carbocation and this is 1 degree carbocation. 3 degree is more stable. Okay?